It's mid-afternoon at Crook Street, and the shunter draws the ex-pig train wagons to the yard, releasing the arrival engine, an LNWR G1, better known to railwaymen and enthusiasts alike as a Super D. As the wagons are propelled into the yard and the Super D retires to the steam shed, the 10 past 2 Kenyon Junction motor train service arrives into the bay. The big goods engine proceeds to the turntable to gain access to the coal hole, where it will be coaled, watered and serviced. Nothing happens quickly on the railways, so this is a slow process. Mind you, he's due out on the Edge Hill goods at 2:45, so he can't take too long. At 2:23, another Manchester Exchange passenger arrives, this one from the usual route via Row Green Junction. The next goods departure is the Edge Hill Goods, which comprises wagons from the 1:30 and 2:30 Deansgate trips. This requires the shunter to work smartly to dispose of the pig train wagons, draw forward and run round the 1:30 Deansgate wagons, and then add the 2:30 Deansgate wagons when they arrive. You'll need a brew after that lot. At last, time to get a brew on and give the youngster driving the trip engine a bit of a rigging. He's a past cleaner, and he's been given the chance to drive by the proper book driver, who just happens to be his dad. And everyone knows the old man, who's on light duty due to his advancing years, likes to get his head down in the shunter's cabin whilst the inspectors aren't looking. Meanwhile, in the steam shed, the Super D draws forward to be turned. On the passenger side, the signalman pulls off for the Kenyan motor train, due out at 2:35. It's only 5 minutes before the next Manchester departure, so signalmen and engine crews have to work seamlessly to make sure all the lines are clear and engines work briskly to meet the tight timetabling. With the passenger train safely clear of the station section, the Super D can set back onto the main lines to make its way to the yard to collect its train. And by the fascinating but labour-intensive efforts of two shunting engine crews, a couple of shunters, the shed turner and coal men, as well as the signalman and the train's driver, fireman and guard, the 245 Edgehill Goods gets underway on time.